Ladies and gentlemen, we will begin our ceremony in a short while.
Dear graduates, you entered junior college as tiny new droplets. Eventually, you started to form small clouds, working together. As you grew and matured, you moved together and saw past your minor differences. You realized that great things could be achieved when many clouds came together. As this small storm gathered strength, you spoke louder and asked more questions. At the end of your junior college education,
ladies and gentlemen, we will begin our ceremony in a short while. Secondary life raises us into the persons that we are. There are great memories, some good and some bad. But these learning experiences and the friends we make along the way will take us on to the next phase of our lives. Someone once said that although no one could go back and make a brand new start, anyone could start from now and make a brand new ending. Look back with fondness as you close this chapter and open the new one that lies ahead.
Many schools around the world, as you know, have shut down, some for extended periods of time, as this virus spreads.
As of 2020, this should be a time to celebrate. Instead, graduation ceremonies are on hold. No caps, no gowns, no goodbyes.
And I want to see it all, like, pan out. And I don't want it to just end. And I don't want it to just end.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. Graduating is a big achievement under any circumstances. I got that from the opening statement of Barack Obama. Some of you have to overcome serious obstacles in life, along with the usual challenges of growing up. And all of you have to deal with the added pressure of social media, keeping up with the latest trend, what to post in Instagram, how many followers do you have in TikTok. Sometimes you focus more on this things than studying. But the thing is, like, it's okay. You're already graduate, right? As long as you don't forget to study, you can do all these things. Now, then the sudden change in our normal life.
Is time really up? Oh my God! You're graduating, and that means you're entering a new phase in life. You may still be uncertain of what exactly you want to do in your life, but please be assured that God's guiding hand is always there for you. To the ones staying back for junior college, I applaud you for your decision. You are in really good hands. You may think it is tough even before you begin, but tell me, didn't Thomas Edison found 1,000 ways it could not work before he finally found one way that it did? To the ones choosing to leave the school to continue the education journey elsewhere, farewell, and remember that you always have my best wishes. To everyone, thank you for accepting me as one of your teachers, confidant, and friend. You will be dearly missed. Good luck, and congratulations.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. The only way you comes, you'll say, I did it all. Give me a second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar, and I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget, but between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
Time to cut them off, I need her. I know how to make the girl go crazy when you treat her like your number one baby.
Ladies and gentlemen, as this is a virtual ceremony, as we call in your classes, we would like to invite you to post your comments in the chat box to show your class spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the graduates from Secondary 4, Pascal. And the graduates from Secondary 4, Newton. Heads of department and fellow teachers. Mr. Li Tingjian, Senior Principal, Binabangs School, Kebunjaruk. Mr. Richard Herawati, Principal, Binabangs School, Kebunjaruk. Mr. Mohan, Vice Principal, Binabangs School, Kebunjaruk. And Mr. Paolo Sia, Director of Academic Supervision, Binabangs School. May we now request everyone to stand for the singing of the National Anthem and School Song. The National Anthem will be led by Ms. Sidevi, and the School Song will be led by our school choir.
Indonesia, tanah airku, tanah tumpah darahku. Di sanalah aku berdiri, jadi penuh ibuku. Indonesia, kebangsaan.
and gentlemen, please be seated. To our distinguished guests, Mr. Paul Osia, Director of Academic Supervision, Mr. Lee Teng Jian, Senior Principal, Mr. Richard Herawati, our Principal, dear parents, graduates, teachers, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant good morning to you and welcome to Binabangsa School's Commencement Ceremony of 2020. To our dear graduates, it is indeed a little disheartening to work your way for years and look forward to reaching that milestone, graduation, only to be struck by this pandemic. You went from working in a classroom to home-based learning. And now, your traditional standard graduation has turned into a virtual one. Graduating amidst a coronavirus pandemic will have lasting implications on you, class of 2020. Today, you are at a defining moment that even in the midst of a global crisis, there is hope as we move forward with the challenging times. To begin today's ceremony, we would like to invite Mr. Donnie to lead us in the opening prayer.
Let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Let us bow down our heads and let us pray. Heavenly Father, we admit that we are troubled with the present situation. COVID-19 has affected us in many ways. However, life must not stop, and it must not prevent us to find a thousand reasons to live according to your purpose, according to your design. Psalm 23 says, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." Today, thank you for giving us another reason to celebrate. On this day, we thank you for supplying the needs of all the graduates. Truly, it was not an easy journey. There were times that they were discouraged. There were times that they were shaken. There were times that they don't know what will they be doing. But during those times, your divine intervention brought them peace and comfort. Thank you, for you are our shepherd. Thank you for your presence is always there for everyone. Thank you for this success. Today is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. But together we say thank you for all the parents that we have, for all our teachers, and we thank you also for giving us Binabangsa. I pray that you bless the graduates of the school year 2020. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
At this point, it is with great pleasure that we call on Mr. Richard Herawati, Principal of Binabangsa School, Kebunchuruk, to give the opening address.
2020 will be remembered as a special year. It is because it is an important milestone of your lives. There are also other reasons, and I will mention a few. First, as we all know, this year, the world has encountered a pandemic. We will remember the year of your graduation is the year where we heard about coronavirus, COVID-19. It has turned the world upside down, inside out, spin off out of its axis. A lot of governments are scrambling for help. A lot of businesses are thinking ways of helping themselves and making sure they stay afloat. Schools have been closed. And this is the time that you are graduating. This is the 21st century. The second reason is that this is the 21st century. This is the year of technology. This is the era of, "Hey Siri, what's the weather like?" This is the year of, "Hey Google, can you let me know this new band?" This is the year of Alexa, can you turn off the air condition? Everything is simplified, everything is almost touchless, everything is almost very advanced, as if we are living in a sci-fi movie. Technology is around us, yes. This is the era of instant. We wake up, we pick our phone up, we press a few buttons, 15 minutes after, your breakfast is served on the front gate. This is the era of Gojek delivery and Grab delivery. Your dinner, your lunch is all served from different restaurants to your doorstep. The world has changed. And of course, the other change is the TikTok. It made its fame in 2019 and 2020, and I wouldn't want to mention it, and I don't want to do TikTok today. The last one is this. This is something new. A lot of entrepreneurs are born. Almost like every day they are new entrepreneurs. And I know, actually, some of you have started your own bakery. You have started selling cookies. You've started selling drinks, boba, jelly, brown sugar, milk tea drink. Some of you may be a YouTuber. Some of you have started to think about being an influencer. Or you have done so already. This is the year 2020. This is what is happening. Your graduation is a milestone. It will always be remembered. Do not forget, Bina Bangsa has done a lot of things this academic year. We have hosted the World Scholar Cup. We have join HMCA. Some of you may have joined HMCA. We have planned and hosted for the BBS MUN, Model United Nation, joined by all Bina Bangsa students. Bina Bangsa has done so much this academic year. First, we have hosted the World Scholar Cup. There are many students joining that event from our schools, from different Bina Bangsa schools, and even from overseas. Second, we also have joined HMCA. Some of you have joined HMCA. Harvard Model Congress Asia. We also planned and hosted BBS Model United Nation in March, just before schools closing down. We had our fun sports day. We had our annual orchestra performance. It was really excellent. We had many, many events in the school, including the Independence Day, including the Christmas celebration, including a lot of different partnership of juniors and seniors teaching and learning for the academics. I would like to thank you if you have participated in teaching your juniors. So my message for you is this. There are a few of you who have contributed. There are many of you who have participated in the events. But there are some of you who are still watching from the sidelines. You observe, but you haven't taken any action to contribute. So I would like you to take your first step. Stop being a watcher. Start participating and contributing. You are going to JC levels. It's time for you to start participating in your CCA. Try to contribute into leadership if you haven't done so. Even start thinking or planning of an organization that you can start and contribute for. It doesn't have to be in the school. It will be good if it is, but you can start anywhere. Do not worry to start. We all make mistakes, and it's human to make mistakes. Most importantly is to learn from your mistakes. The last point I want to make is this. JC is an important part of your life. Why is it important? Because this is a time for you also to plan, to find out your passions, to pursue careers in universities. When you take your bachelor degree, when you take your master degree, you have decided for your career. JC is a time for you to plan. For those of you who are going to college, you may need to also start thinking, after college, what are you going to do? If you decided to come back to JC in Bina Bangsa, that will be good for you. Now, after you are being active and start planning, you will start knowing what you want to do in the future. It's better to start early than you have problems later. So remember my two messages today. First, be active. Contribute. Don't worry to make mistakes. Make sure you learn from your mistakes. That's one. Second, start planning. Start thinking about your future. This is a time for you to make the decisions for your university and career. And I hope the best for all of you. And I see you next academic year in JC. Thank you and have a good day.
Thank you, Mr. Richard. Today's guest speaker is no stranger to the BBS family. She is currently the associate consultant at Payment Company. In her years in BBS, she aced her A-levels with 4 A-stars and 1 A. She was also a 2-time valedictorian with a long string of achievements. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Cecilia Natasha.
Dear graduating class of 2020, congratulations. You've achieved another milestone in your life. All those hours spent attending back-to-back classes, preparing for mock exams, and cramming through extreme papers, it all came down to this day. You should give yourself a pat on the back and say, good job. Time really flies. I mean, I was in your shoes around half a decade ago. Wow, that makes me feel really old. When I think about graduation, it definitely brings in a lot of mixed emotions. A feeling of accomplishment as I walked into the assembly hall wearing my cap and gown, with a graduation entrance song in the background as I waved to my parents to show them, I did it, Mom and Dad. A feeling of nostalgia as I flashback through all the past memories. From chit-chatting over random things in the canteen until lunch bell rings, getting the sapam to help us buy the most delicious indomie and ketoprak right outside the building, to choir practices at BBS PIC to prepare for our annual concert. A feeling of sadness knowing that all of us will be parting ways. And lastly, a feeling of excitement to experience what lies ahead. Based on my experience, I can tell you, college will definitely be one of the best times of your life. If I could describe college in one word, it would be freedom. Freedom to choose your major, freedom to choose the classes that you want to take, freedom to set your own schedule, and the list goes on and on. But like the infamous quote from the movie Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibilities. As you have been entrusted with the power to craft your own college experience, you are therefore also accountable for all the decisions that you make. Looking back at my own college experience, these are the few things that I would have told my 18-year-old self before she embarked on her college journey. First, find your community. Be it ethnic, like an Indonesian student organization, religious, or any specific interest groups. College is a concrete jungle. Coming from an enclosed environment with about 15 to 20 students per classroom, to attending lecture halls with hundreds of students from various backgrounds, can make you feel lonely. Find a group of people whom you can trust and will support you along the way. Second, seize any opportunity that is provided to you, be it to take on leadership positions or to volunteer in various events. Like what Jeff Bezos, the founder of Amazon, said, "I knew that if I failed, I wouldn't regret that, but I knew the one thing that I might regret is not trying." Third, don't compare yourself to others. Compare yourself to the person you were yesterday. Coming into college, you'll meet with a lot of really intelligent and accomplished individuals. It's easy to fall into the comparison trap and have your self-esteem go down the hill. Remind yourself that everyone has their own life story. You may be in chapter one, but that person might just be in chapter five. Lastly, don't forget to have fun, but not too much fun. College is like a Venn diagram between study, social life, and sleep. Make sure you strike a balance between these three elements. Today, all of us are going through unprecedented times. There are lots of uncertainties, things are constantly changing, and there seems to be no light at the end of the tunnel yet. But rather than worrying about what lies ahead, focus on carpe diem. Seizing the day. You can't change yesterday, but you can ruin today by worrying about tomorrow. Once again, congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. You deserve to be proud of this moment, and best of luck for the next journey ahead. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Cecilia. Dear graduates, this is a gentle reminder that we will be switching to live via Google Meet after the presentation of certificates. You will need to be in your robes and mortar boards for the turning of the tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a tradition in every commencement ceremony that one outstanding student is chosen to give a speech on behalf of his or her schoolmates. To present this year's valedictorian for Secondary 4, please welcome Mr. Ruhel, form teacher of Secondary 4, Newton.
Respected Director Mr. Paulus, school principals Mr. TJ and Mr. Richard, esteemed colleagues, proud parents, and graduating students, a pleasant morning. Congratulations, class of 2020. Let us celebrate your milestone in a very unique, virtual, and personal way. It has never happened before, and we pray that this crisis will never happen again. I'm extremely proud to announce this year's school's valedictorian, Felicia Suryawinata, for she works diligently for the past 4 years. Felicia can be described as humble, given all of her accomplishments. Her confidence, curiosity, determination, and kindness makes her an exemplary student. She works hard and focused on striving to be better. Thank you for sharing your gift of joy and humor. It makes my class lively. But most of the time, we get distracted. But truly, I enjoy your jokes and funny antics. We hope with what is happening in the world now, enlighten you not just about the kind of future you want for yourself, but for the kind of leaders, nation builders, agent of change, and catalyst of progress you need to become to create a future that is good, true, and beautiful for mankind. My dear graduating students, I have seen your blood, sweat, and tears you invested so that you could proudly walk on stage in 2020 as young men and women who will set the world on fire with our school values, integrity, teamwork, passion, determination, compassion, and ability to aspire. We are so proud of what you have accomplished and who you have become. So once again, with great pride and joy, I now present to you our valedictorian for this academic year, Felicia Surya Winata.
Good morning, honorable guests, heads of the school, teachers, family, friends, and the distinguished class of 2020. Dear graduates, it is with great honor to speak on this day to commemorate your achievements. I have mixed feelings about graduating, joyful that I finally completed my secondary education, but sorrowful to leave this marvelous and extraordinary community. To the tenacious students who have survived 4 laborious years of secondary school, congratulations. You haven't really grasped how amazing each one of you is. You had studied multiple subjects and were able to retain all of the information you study to put it in words or numbers in your tests. For those disappointed with their final grades, don't be. We all have different talents, like Clarice and Evelyn with their sharp dances, Kenji with his amazing taste of fashion, Joy, Josh, Tracy, and Isabel with their athletic abilities, and Evelyn, Sophia, and Jason with their prodigious drawings. The numbers on your report card does not define your chance of success. To the heroic teachers who so generously shared their precious time with us to make sure we understood the lesson, repeated explanations, give us homework so we didn't stack off at home, you all have spilled sweat and tears just for us to be successful. Your success is our success. To the tolerant parents and supportive brothers and sisters who have pushed us to study when we were unmotivated, took care of us when we didn't take care of ourselves, took away our phones when we were too distracted, you paved the way so we can walk. I would like to speak on behalf of the class of 2020 and say thank you to the teachers and our family for the amount of effort you all have put in for us. We would like to repay all the work you have done. However, we definitely are not yet able to help you the way you have helped us. So, the best way we can repay this debt is to maximize and use the opportunity and wisdom you gave us to make our future brighter. You guys are the epitome of the quote, "Not all heroes wear capes." We hope we have made you proud. Stick with me, graduates. This isn't an Oscar speech. Usually, the valedictorian would give advice to the graduates straight away. But I would like to take this time to evaluate what advice I've received from you. Writing this speech made me realize that BBS is full of inspiration. I've been searching for inspiration for this speech on the internet when it's just right in front of me, theoretically that is. My classmates were always persistent in getting good grades and passionate about their studies. I learned that it is not the grades that matter, but how you obtain them. For example, during maths class, I had always tried the best I could, but I always refused to ask for help until I was stressed and burnt out. My classmates never struggled to ask for help. When I did ask for help, I understood the question more and was finally able to answer it. To those of you having the same problem, please don't hesitate to ask for help from others around you. Two or more brains are better than one. A school is where we learn. BBS is just a place. But we are the community that makes BBS a school. Being a part of Pinabangsa is such an exclusive experience which taught me many lessons and values. We teach and inspire each other every day and we don't even realize it. A simple word or an act of kindness is all it takes to influence someone. We might even have changed someone we don't know without realizing the impact. It is finally time to leave you to reflect on a few of my memorable moments. Throughout my 4 years here, I've gained many of them. From doing TikTok dances after school, to preparing for competitions. There's this one moment that keeps repeating itself, like deja vu. After every difficult test, in the midst of everyone clarifying their answers with each other, there's always this one-liner that we claim defeatedly. I think I'm going to fail. When I was browsing Instagram, I came across a quote saying, "Replace the word problem with the word opportunity in your thought." So I thought, the coronavirus is a really big opportunity in Indonesia. The quote doesn't apply to everything, but the person who made that quote had the right mindset. Studies showed that optimism increases motivation. I don't think there's even a need for research, it's just common sense. Optimism does not only help you, but it helps others because other values can be developed like compassion. Besides, laughter is the best medicine after all. A pessimistic mindset is unhealthy for you. Your brain is programmed to respond to negative emotions by shutting off the outside world and limiting the options you see around you. Let's say you have to run 2.4 kilometers for PE, but you don't think you can do it. You could either try to finish or not try at all, but since you're disappointed in yourself, you choose the latter. How do I know so much about it? I have negative thoughts too. Humans have flaws. This is why we need to support each other by opening the eyes of those blinded by their negative emotions and thoughts. Keep this mantra as we go our separate ways. Yes, it can be a struggle to develop positive thinking. Let's be frank here. 2020 hasn't really been a good year. There's a new fiasco every month and the future looks grim. However, every cloud has a silver lining. Train your mind to look at the good in every aspect. For instance, the lockdown brought everyone closer and revealed true friendships that will last years if it can survive this. Optimism is a choice. You are not born optimistic or pessimistic. You can suddenly be optimistic one day. But if you keep trying, you'll be searching for the silver lining and hoping for the best unconsciously. You can immediately feel the difference. You're happier, livelier, more motivated, and more passionate. Whenever you're feeling down and pessimistic, I would like you to remember these lyrics from So Will I by Ben Platt. The sky will still be up there, and the sun will always shine. The stars will keep on falling for the ones who wish at night. The mountains won't start moving, and the rivers won't run dry. The world will always be there. Thank you.
Thank you, Felicia. As you close a chapter of your secondary life, look onto the beauty of believing your dreams and working towards making those dreams a reality. Welcome the music department, along with some members of the school choir, with their performance of A Million Dreams, and envision the bright future that awaits.
Waiting up for me that I call my own. they can say it all sounds easy.
For that wonderful performance. And now we shall move on to the presentation of certificates. The following graduates have been awarded the Secondary Education Certificate of Completion. We would like to invite the form teachers to call in the names of the graduates from their respective classes. Please welcome the form teachers, Ms. Jacqueline for Secondary 4 Pasco, and Mr. Ruhel for Secondary 4, Newton.
The graduating class of Secondary 4, Pascal. To begin with, Angeline Kusuma, Carmen Lee, Christopher Tenedi, Ivan Laxmana, Jason Naftali, Joanne Hartato, Josephine Annabelle Jasmine, Joshua Pan Mulia, Matthew Ree Shing Tang, Maxel The Kutama, Natalie Chai, Nicholas Wijaya, Oscar Taja, Russell Gabriel Effendi, Vincent Ryan Vinata, and last but not least, William Hansen Tanu Wijaya.
The Dread Ones from Secondary 4 Mini. Clarice Vivian Go. Evelyn Chen. Irling Angeline Lin. Felicia Surya Linara. Gabriela Amanda. Isabel Willy. Jaislyn Sirta Jaya. Jocelyn Wahon, Kenji Karyose, Lee Cynthia, Naomi Sarah Lien, Shania Alexandra Spar, Sophia Putri Limanto, Tracy Trinita Siddhartha, William Prajna Gunawan, Winston Gaga Dinindra.
Thank you very much, form teachers. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to switch to Google Meet. Kindly follow the instructions on your screen. See you there.